I said there was going to be a lot of work involved in thinning that out. I'm going to use the smaller end on there. It shouldn't be too difficult. The reason why I'm using the smaller end is because I'm able to take off smaller flakes, which puts less stress on the point. So we'll see how this goes. We'll take some off from the ends first, just to get a little bit of practice before we tackle the ones in the middle. This is kind of risky because of the stiff fractures right there. I should probably make that more concave. It's hard to support the tip, but I'm going to try just in case. Got the tip wedged in there. Too bad. There's a strange crack in here. I don't know if you can see it. See where the cortex is. Well, the depth of the cracks from the outside of the stone have actually come in deep enough to affect this particular point. So it's a good thing we're going to clear that out. But those cracks can really make your work very unpredictable. Make your strikes unpredictable. I'm just going to try to slowly wear it down. Basic flint napping there, eliminating the sharp edge so I can remove some flakes without crushing the edge. The camera is kind of in a weird position. I actually had trouble with the, well not trouble, but in reviewing my videos I could hear a noise from the microphone that couldn't figure out what it was, and I think it was the cord of the microphone rubbing up against the little setup I've got here. It was creating some kind of a low rustling type of sound. I hope that's gone now. I've actually got the microphone hanging down and not touching anything. Okay. I get lazy and I don't set up the platform sometimes. But at this stage, I really can't afford to do anything wrong or take any shortcuts. So I'm going to try to explain my thought processes as I go, and also try not to show you any bad habits that I've got.